Stephen Hauk, only on News 42. It's about time.
Look, if you had one shot, or one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, would you capture it?
That question is on the minds of the nation's leading collegiate dance teams. The preparations are history now. Their performances are all about to begin. Beauty, grace, and athleticism will be on display. The soaring cheerleaders face the same query. Months of practice to arrive at this moment. Are you ready to stick that routine? Are you ready to be the champions? To Daytona Beach, Florida for the Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship. This beach ravaged by hurricanes just over 6 months ago, but now returned to its pristine beauty and is once again a hub of outdoor activity. Today, the focus is on the Daytona Beach Bandshell. Hello, everybody. I'm Craig Venervini with gold medalist, former captain of the 1996 U.S. Olympic gymnastic team, Amanda Borden. Welcome to the beach here in Daytona. Hey, the big story in cheer and dance centers around the University of Louisville these days. They're unbelievable. They've won three straight championships in dance. They're also two-time defending champs in cheer.
That's right. All eyes are on Louisville, both on the stage and off the stage. In fact, a lot of the cheer squads here in Daytona told us they model their program after the Cardinals. And at this competition, they are the team to beat. They've won 10 titles since 1985. And this year in cheer, they're looking for a three-peat.
We'll get to the cheer competition in a little bit. First, though, in dance, plenty of excellent teams, including former power BYU, the Lady Cougarettes, number one in the prelims.
Between BYU and Louisville, they've won 7 of the last 8 titles, but this year it looks like BYU has found a little bit of their old magic. They have not won since 2001, but they dominated the prelims, and although Louisville has won the last 3 years, it's going to be tough to beat BYU.
All right, we're going to head over to the band show for the competition. First, though, let's go to the third member of our team, Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, Craig. With preliminary scores thrown out and every team starting from scratch, this competition is wide open. Keep an eye out, though, for the University of North Carolina that's trying to ride in the heels of their basketball team and win a championship of their own. The Tar Heels finished third in prelims thanks to a performance that head coach Mark Lichkowski said was one of their best ever. Another showing like that, and they can have their first championship in school history.
More with Tracy throughout the show. We begin the competition with Rutgers, the Scarlet Knights, in their fifth year here in Daytona Beach. Amanda, the dance is required to perform in palm, jazz, and funk.
That's right. They're required to perform at least 30 consecutive seconds of all three styles.
The routine cannot exceed 2 minutes and 15 seconds.
They're moving into the palm section right here. They're not required to use a palm in their hand, but what the judges are looking for is sharp, strong arm motions as well as uniformity and synchronization.
Their motto is the dance as one, and you can see that here in this part of the routine. The head coach is Christine Zoffinger in her seventh year. She's also 7 months pregnant, and along with her coaching staff, they all made their own costumes this year. Christine told us it's the first time she ever used a sewing machine. It was a Christmas present from her mom, and they just finished the costumes a few days ago.
They're transitioning into the jazz section of the routine. This is where we're going to see a lot of technical skills with an emphasis on body placement, style, and control. Performing fuetes in second, very fast pace, makes it very difficult.
They had some deductions, were ninth in the prelims, but the raw score was an impressive 9.2, overall 8.6.
Here's the street style dance I was talking about as they move into the hip hop or funk section. They use a lot of body isolations in this style of dance, which can be very difficult to keep the group synchronized.
Well, they've been fourth the last 2 years, third the 2 years before that. Their quest today was to try and move up into the top two at the very least. A nice routine for Rutgers, the Scarlet Knights again. Amanda, what is the judging criteria?
Well, they're looking for five different technical areas: the dance fundamentals, jazz technique, palm technique, funk technique, and technical skills.
A 9.04, so much better than their preliminary score, and anything over the nines considered very good. But is it enough to complete their goal? That will be the challenge. Here are the Dancing Devils from Duke.
You can see in the back there, Craig, they're actually using a chair as a prop. They chose a very simple prop in the past. They felt like they were a little propped out, they said. Wow, look at this. Right in the front, Dana Kulik, beautiful turns here. Nice wet days in second, pirouetting.
Beginning with the jazz portion of their routine. That's the coach's discretion. As long as they get the 30 consecutive seconds in each of the styles of dance, jazz, palm, and funk. They've been coming here for 7 years with their head coach, Marcus Walker. They finished as high as fourth overall.
Picking up the pace as they move into the palm section.
Of course, the competition, unusual for dancers in that it's outside. What does that present to them?
Well, you know, they're looking out into a big crowd, number one. When they're turning outside, they have four different spots here, which can be very difficult to stay synchronized, on top of the factor of the sun and the wind.
And the heat, too, as the day moves on. They move into the funk section, and you can see the smiles on their faces. You talk to all these dancers, Amanda, they'll all tell you this is their favorite part.
I think it's because the crowd really gets into it at that point. They love seeing the street style dance. But they're finishing with their strength, which is the technique style. Showing nice flexibility on all their leaps and jumps. Great job.
Before we get to the Duke score, let's check out some of the other finalists in our Southwest Airlines dance recap. A nice performance for Clemson. They won the Challenge Cup, beating out 10 teams to earn a spot in the finals.
University of South Carolina with their first time at the finals. They're coached by Michelle Fields, finishing with an 8.71.
Jill Peterson's Iowa State team improved their prelim score as they make the finals here in Daytona Beach.
We have a score for Duke.
Top three to the left.
8.97.
So Duke moves into second place, but Rutgers remains in front.
CBS Sports Spectacular presents Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship, sponsored by Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. Daytona Beach. This year, make time for Daytona Beach. And by Southwest Airlines. No matter what direction you're flying, you'll be going Southwest.
Biggest splash? The new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A. Rebuilt from the wheat bun up, it's our best char-grilled chicken sandwich ever.
Ding!
You are now free to dip your toes in the ocean.
Ding!
Ding!
You are now free to see an old friend.
To forget what traffic sounds like.
Free to find your favorite state flower.
Ding. Ding.
That ding is just cracking me up.
You are now free to get a low fare, even at the last minute.
Ding.
Ding.
You are now free to follow your favorite team.
Ding. Ding.
You're now free to enjoy low fares coast to coast.
With frequent nonstops to 59 cities.
You are now free to move about the country.
There's a stretch of sparkling white sand that runs for 23 miles along Florida's east coast. Some call it relaxing. Some, a playground. Some call it Daytona Beach. But most simply call it fun. Call toll-free now for a free Daytona Beach visitor guide and superior small lodging brochure filled with affordable vacation ideas. The water's warm. The natives are friendly. All you have to do is make time.
New from Secret. Body sprays.
Oh, yeah!
Discover the Secret body spray that goes with your style. And smell great. Anytime, anywhere.
Sweet.
Find us near your other favorite Secret products.
Plenty of great outdoor activities here on an 80-degree day. What better way to cool off than the Daytona Lagoon? Have to make plans to do that next year. Great fun at this Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship. We move on with the dance competition, and this is North Carolina.
Let's go, Carolina.
They finished third in prelims, and he said it was the best performance he'd ever seen from his team.
This is North Carolina's first time in the finals since they finished second, their best finish ever. That was back in 97 here in Daytona Beach.
They said they know there are a lot of big-time teams here, and sometimes that makes them in awe, but this time they wanted to just come out here, do their job, and believe in themselves.
Good hard-hitting start here, too, for North Carolina. Grabs the audience's attention right off the bat. And the judges, too.
That's right. This is their jazz portion of the routine. They move into a turn combination, fuetes in second, changing the leg position slightly, as well as the arm position, ending with a tilt kick.
Compliments on their outfits to senior Viviana Buez, who is on the squad and made the top this year. The seamstress did a great job and had the perfect Tar Heel color, too. And Carolina Blue.
Wrapping up their palm section. Watch right here in the front as they move into the funk section. They have a specialist. They call her JoJo Dancer. She's front and center right here.
Janelle Joyner, a freshman with a little body but a big attitude, according to the coach, Mark Lichkowski. That she just came on in practice. They kept watching. She said, what? She is great. What a personality in dancing. She became a feature.
Very nice fuetes in second. Again, changing that arm position. Very difficult to keep the center.
UNC Chapel Hill with a fine performance here in the finals. Let's take a look at a few of the other teams that made finals for Penn State. Their best performance ever here in Daytona Beach. Missed the finals by a tenth of a point a year ago. Well, a terrific performance, 8.90.
NC State tied for fourth in the prelims, and Coach Natalie Hageman and April Frazier both very excited and satisfied with their final score of an 8.78.
Miami University of Ohio, their first trip ever to the Nationals. Head coach Erin Treptow, in her first year, has to be enthused about this program.
And Ohio State performing a going back in time theme, getting an 8.77 using music from the 60s, 70s, and 80s.
Here's the score for UNC.
For the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill.
9.18 Army meters.
So North Carolina takes over the lead. Rutgers moving into second with a 9.18.
Good.
The three-time defending champion Louisville Cardinals are up next, but missing a very important part of their program. Here's Tracy with more.
The Louisville dance team is without a key member of their squad today. Head coach Cheryl Knight just gave birth to a little lady bird, a baby girl named Christian Kathleen. Obviously, she can't be here, but she will get a play-by-play account thanks to a cell phone. Here's assistant head coach Todd Sharp, who's on the phone with her right now. Cheryl Knight, are you ready to listen?
That's got to be an agonizing phone call for Cheryl. And such excitement as Todd Sharp looks on at his Lady Birds. This year's second in the prelims with a 9.29. Here are the Lady Birds going after their fourth straight Division 1A dance championship.
It's a very dynamic team as well as routine. They start right out into their jazz section. They do a lot of layering right there in the beginning, highlighting individual strengths, but they pull it back together. Beautiful pirouettes.
Scored as high as 9.7 here in the jazz category in the prelims yesterday. Brought in a choreographer, Carl Monk from Oregon, to help them out there.
They actually do a full minute of jazz. They're only required 30 seconds. Again, Fuentes in second, changing the arm position. Very nice.
Three seniors on this team have never lost. Stephanie Beaumont, Kristen Frickman, and Tiffany Smith. Looking for that fourth ring here at Daytona Beach.
Moving into the funk section.
This is what they're known for right here.
It's a very athletic team. They said they want to make the audience get up and dance. They do a great job of dancing as one. This can be a very difficult section of the routine to stay in unison.
Some will layer it, not the Lady Birds. It looks like they are dancing as one. 19 on the floor, including seven freshmen.
This is the part of the routine they're most confident about. Palm section. Show a variety of jumps. Again, this is a very athletic team. They have strong jumps.
Oh, how about that cell phone call to Cheryl Knight? Did the Lady Birds do it again?
I think throughout the routine, Todd Sharp was getting into the routine as much as the dancers were.
Cheryl wishing Todd splurged for the video phone instead.
Cheryl!
All right, Cheryl, they did awesome.
Back in a moment with the Louisville score, and you gotta love the way they move.
We got you something. Southwest has new leather seats and roomier cabins for more comfortable flights.
I love leather.
You are now free to move about the country.
There's a stretch of sparkling white sand that runs for 23 miles along Florida's east coast. Some call it relaxing. Some, a playground. Some call it Daytona Beach. But most simply call it fun. Call toll-free now for a free Daytona Beach visitor guide and superior small lodging brochure filled with affordable vacation ideas. The water's warm. The natives are friendly. All you have to do is make time.
New from Secret. Body sprays.
Oh, yeah!
Discover the Secret body spray that goes with your style. And smell great. Anytime, anywhere.
Sweet.
Find us near your other favorite Secret product.
It's a wild shootout. The top golfers on the PGA Tour are in Texas as Vijay Singh defends his title at the Shell Houston Open. Next on CBS.
Welcome back to beautiful Daytona Beach, waiting on the Louisville score. So let's check in now with Tracy Wolfson.
For a few of these BYU dancers, this season has been even more hectic than usual. Not only are they trying to balance school and practice, they're also planning weddings. There are four newly engaged girls on this team, one who never saw it coming.
Well, we just had our concert, which is we do five shows, and they were all sold out, by the way. And on the final show, we were at the end doing our bows, and they hand out roses to all the girls. And they skipped me, and I was kind of offended because I'm one of the older girls on the team, thinking, why would they skip me? And then he came out with this long stem single rose, got on his knee in front of everyone. That's when he proposed.
That's great. What are the dates of when you guys are getting married? Any dates set yet?
Yeah.
All set.
Well, yeah. It goes May, June, July, and August.
Guys, I asked the four of them if their fiancés are here, and they all said, sadly, no coaches' rules, no distractions.
Thanks, Tracy. Well, the Cougarettes know what they have to do now. Louisville has taken over the top spot in the standings with a 9.43 for their performance. Will it be good enough to win a fourth straight national championship? It's an action-packed routine for the Cougarettes. On the floor, 19 dancers, including five freshmen and seven sophomores.
Starting out with their fun section, they actually chose to do that this year. It's 45 seconds, and they said it really relaxes them so they can dance like they can dance. A couple years back, BYU was known for not having enough funk in their routine. Last year, it wasn't enough pom. They said it was disappointing because they feel like when you've got technique, you can do anything.
They set the standard, winning 4-5 up until 2001. Then the Lady Birds took over. The question is now, is there enough for the Cougarettes this year to knock off the three-time defending champion Louisville Cardinals?
Moving into the Jazz section, very nice. Traditional dance lift. They have beautiful lines. They have the long black legs, again, showing extension. They have great flexibility and toe points. Woo! Catching our attention.
Coach Joni Maxfield telling us her husband Scott was watching the routine eating ice cream. Said, you can't look down. For 1 second, you're going to miss five things.
That's right. Here's what they're known for. Beautiful fuetes in second. Beautiful turn combination. Wow.
Very elegant, as always. Largest dance program in the country. Over 4,000 students take dance classes at BYU.
Very fast pace. They said they want to come back and nail this part of the routine. Synchronization. Beautiful routine.
Oh, nicely done for Brigham Young University.
An element like a costume change, which we're going to see right here, really enhances the overall effect of the routine.
We have the score for Brigham Young University.
BYU has to beat Louisville's 9-4-3.
9.55.
They did it.
And national champions Brigham Young University.
They did it again. Brigham Young is back on top.
Congratulations, Jody, and congratulations to all the BYU team. knock off a Louisville squad that has won three straight championships. How did you guys do it today?
Well, I'll tell you, these girls have heart. I held this up as they walked onto the stage. Our whole motto this year has been believe, and they believe they could do it.
What a way to go out. Finally, your first win since 2001. What does it mean to this program to be back on top?
This is huge for us. I mean, we really have worked hard for this. We felt like we knew we've always had it. Last year we had some problems, so we really wanted to be able to come here this year and demonstrate what our program is all about.
Well, thanks a lot. Congratulations to Jody and all the Homie
Wonder
team. Thank you. Louisville dethroned in the dance competition, but they still have a chance to win a national championship here. Their cheer team looking very good in the prelims. They had the top overall raw score, but a major deduction left them in third.
That's right. The deduction came with an inappropriate gesture. However, they've made adjustments to the routine, and they still are the favorites. The surprise team was Clemson. They won the prelims. They've never been in this position before. In fact, the best finish ever was seventh place. And although they like being first coming into the finals, they do know it will take a near-perfect routine to win their first ever national championship.
All right, the cheer squads take the stage when we return to the Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship from Daytona Beach, Florida.
Biggest splash? The new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A. Rebuilt from the wheat bun up, it's our best char-grilled chicken sandwich ever.
Nobody does it like Southwest Airlines. We always have low fares, even at the last minute.
You are now free to move about the country.
There's a stretch of sparkling white sand that runs for 23 miles along Florida's east coast. Some call it relaxing. Some, a playground. Some call it Daytona Beach. But most simply call it fun. Call toll-free now for a free Daytona Beach visitor guide and superior small lodging brochure filled with affordable vacation ideas. The water's warm. The natives are friendly. All you have to do is make time.
New from Secret. Body sprays.
Oh, yeah!
Discover the Secret Body Spray that goes with your style. And smell great. Anytime, anywhere.
Sweet.
Find us near your other favorite Secret products.
Your ultimate online sports experience. For the fastest scores, stats, and first-rate fantasy sports, go to CBSSportsLine.com.
Welcome back to the Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship. The dancers have moved to the beach. Now it's time for the cheer squads to take over the main stage in front of a sellout crowd. These are the Purdue Boilermakers.
And that's the kind of high-flying action we're going to see in these cheer routines, as well as great tumbling. And as a former gymnast, I can tell you that I appreciate their tumbling because they do not have an advantage of being on a spring floor. They are on foam only out here.
They're using the maximum allotment of 20 on the floor, and the routine cannot exceed 2 minutes and 15 seconds, just like the dance competition.
Very solid partner stunts. Again, one of the fundamentals, along with cross tumbling, partner stunts, pyramids, basket tosses, and motions and dance.
They were a little nervous in the prelims, Amanda. Did not perform as well as they had hoped, including their brand new pyramid, which we will see coming up. They stuck it every time until the prelims, but today they look to be in form.
This is where it happened in prelims. They struggled.
Now they actually cartwheel over. Very difficult. They're landing on another base, and they nailed it. Excellent job. Getting ready for a basket toss in the back. Just a tuck X out.
The captains are Jenny Freely and Chris Damjanovic.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth? Don't nobody understand the words that are coming out of your mouth, man.
Second, their best finish ever 3 years ago.
Very nice form on the double twisting basket. Don't want none unless you double up. Performing their motions and dance. Again, another requirement as they build up into a very difficult pyramid. Transitioning, a lot of high flying action. Remember, they can build to 2.5 high. Right here, watch this. She flips over, pops right back up, and they catch her in the back. Oh, the left side dropped. Oh.
That'll be a deduction. And not the stamp they were hoping to finish off their routine with. What are the judges looking for?
They're looking for the cheerleading fundamentals, as well as routine execution, projection, choreography, degree of difficulty, and the overall effect.
We have the score for Purdue University, 8.60.
8.60, a little higher than their prelim score for Purdue.
From Houston, Texas, graduate for the University of Houston.
Here's the University of Houston. And the fans looking forward to their performance. Houston coming off their best performance in school history. They were tied for second a year ago with an 8.95 score. Still a different planet when you compare it to Louisville, which finished with a 9.63 last year.
Very creative partner work. Beautiful heel stretches showing great flexibility. 2 years ago, this team showcased a standing double full, which we had never seen at a collegiate level. Very nice, awesome. Very solid arabesque, double down. Great job.
One man base in the middle, very impressive for Houston. Off to a good start.
They begin cross tumbling. We're gonna see a lot of double pulls at the collegiate level. Very nice full twist as well. And of course, some synchronized tumbling a little bit off there.
Purdue, the team to beat at 8.6.
Houston's having trouble on the right side of the screen. They're a little out of sync. Very nice X double. Right here in the center. I think that was supposed to be some kind of pyramid, actually.
Yeah. Had a little trouble on the left side of the pyramid as well. Out of their motions and dance section again. 1/10 of the score. Does not have to be 30 consecutive seconds like it is in the dance competition, but just have to show it.
A lot of the teams like performing this part of the routine because the crowd really gets into it.
So Houston bidding for another top three for the fourth year in a row. The Cougars score upcoming. Let's take a look, though, at a couple of other performances in our Chick-fil-A cheer recap. Virginia Tech won the Challenge Cup during the final berth here in Daytona Beach.
Middle Tennessee State, this is their second year in a row to make the finals. They're coached by third-year head coach Jonathan Persley, finishing with an 8.16.
We have the score for the University of Houston, 8.78, our new leaders.
So Houston takes over the lead, bumping Purdue to second. We'll have more to come from Daytona Beach. For year-round sports coverage with late-breaking news and notes, plus scores and expert analysis, it's all at CBSSportsLine.com. More after this message and a word from your local station.
Garcia. You're just gonna have to cut this. A little body English goes a long way.
Don't miss TV Guide's movie pick, Locusts. World premiere, CBS tomorrow. Just four teams left and three episodes to go. Don't miss a new Amazing Race, CBS Tuesday.
Want some free money? Put your radio on 98.7 KISS FM.
Here's Daryl Johnson with the 411.
The $1 million birthday game is back. Listen to Tom Joyner weekday mornings at 7:20 on 98.7 KISS FM. We'll announce a birthday. If it matches yours, you can win $1,000 instantly. And on Thursdays, you could win $1 million.
That's a whole lot of chances to win some free money.
The $1 million birthday game is back. Only on 98.7 KISS FM.
Edward Chevrolet offers the best deal. It's the first place you need to go.
Fantastic deal.
Oh, I got a really great deal.
I got a great deal.
There was no hassling or haggling.
I got my payments where I was able to afford them.
The price and financing was great at Edward Chevrolet.
So I got a very good deal at Chevrolet.
Best prices.
Edward Chevrolet is the best place to go.
I got the best price here.
We're just absolutely satisfied.
Nobody beats Edward Chevrolet's deals. Chevy
man. Meteorologist Sarah Black, only on News 42. It's about time.
Greg Benevini back with Amanda Borden. Welcome back to beautiful Daytona Beach, Florida, the Chamber of Commerce Day. Let's go backstage now with Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, guys. For the first time in 2.5 years, Oklahoma State has a head coach cheering them on. And ironically, it's former Louisville assistant Leroy McCullough. Before McCullough arrived in February, the Cowboys had been coaching themselves. Now, in just 3 months, McCullough has instituted mentality and work ethic. He learned at Louisville along with a top-notch routine. And he has this Oklahoma State team back in the mix where it belongs.
Here's how we stand. Houston has the lead with their 8.78 as Oklahoma State gets set to try and best that.
And the Cardinal influence has already had a positive effect on Oklahoma State. Here they are.
The Cowboys, former champions here in 1989, but they find some of the winning spirit from the 80s because they did not make the finals the last 2 years here.
Well, Coach Leroy said, they had 3 months to be able to nail this routine twice. They rewind right up into arabesque. Nice job. Very solid start.
Nice transition on the rewind. That's not easy to pull off, too. We see a lot of those go up, and they kind of stumble sometimes.
Very nice.
Excellent ripple effect.
That's where they struggled in the prelims, was on the right stunt. They dropped. Excellent job. They held it together today.
Getting the doubling section, 1/10 of the score. 5 judges, led by a head judge, also a point deduction and legality judge, 7 overall on the panel.
They're pretty excited about where they finished in prelims because they knew they could hit it a lot better than doing a great job today. Had no touchdowns on their tumbling, and all their stunts have been pretty solid.
Well, head coach Leroy McCullough told us he raised the bar, bringing the Louisville winning mentality over here. But the atmosphere was a bit relaxed when he arrived here. A little more accountable. And their eyes on moving up to one of the best in the business. Wow!
Very nice pyramid. Now they can relax a little bit. They've nailed just about everything so far as they move into the motions and dance.
Nice performance by OSU as the Cowboys look to better the top mark so far. Leroy saying, hey, take that, Cardinals. Nicely done.
That was an outstanding routine. Watch this pyramid as they build up into a triple star, balancing on her hands. Very difficult to stay stable.
We have the score for Oklahoma State University. 8.96, our new leaders in Division 1A.
Oklahoma State has grabbed the lead with their score just shy of 9. NC State up next. First, though, Tracy with the Cowboys coach.
Leroy, congratulations. What a performance. You had to be happy with that one.
I'm very happy with them. With the adversity that the kids have gone through, like, to get to this point, and for them to, our goal was to hit twice, and today was the best performance that they've had. So it was good. I'm really, really happy for them.
The judges gave you an 8.96. What did you think about that score?
Well, I mean, I thought it would have been a little bit higher, but, you know, I mean, they noted on our score sheet that we had a little bit too much assist on our stunts, and talked to the guys about it, and I think I kind of scared them into holding on too much because it was more important for them to stay in the air than drop. So I understand where we got the lower score from, but I was hoping for something a little bigger.
Thanks a lot. Good luck.
No problem. Thank you.
Still, the Cowboys holding the top spot with their score of 8.96 as we get ready for North Carolina State.
That's a love swap.
One of the hardest pyramid known to cheerleading and mankind.
Well, this is what they're known for, the Wolf Wall. This year, a new variation. They actually added an extra level. There was a 2-2-1 right in the center there. Very nice opening.
A squad of 20 for the Wolfpack. 13 guys, 7 girls. 6 of the fellas are new to the team. Former champ here 4 years ago.
Oh, struggled there a little bit. On and off, it came down early. Very creative transition. Right up again, struggling right there in the middle, holding it together as they pull their leg back to a scorpion. Very nice cross tumbling.
There's one mistake to put you out of the running for first.
Well, you know,
that close?
Depending on the kind of mistake, there can be 0.05 taken off all the way up to 0.2. And to be honest with you, it can really make a difference. The main thing is, when they make that mistake, can they pull it back together?
In the past, they've used a secret weapon, sending girls to the weight room, pulling out 2 or 3 guys, and never thought about cheer and wind up on the cheer team.
Very creative transition out of the stud there.
Choreographer Eric Little has worked with a lot of teams, helped put this particular section together. Motion and dance sequence. Not normally his strength for that, but he's done a nice job. I didn't think he could make a non-dancer dance because I've never been able to dance. Off the talk to Eric.
Very nice. Double twist basket with an X in the middle there. Looking for a strong ending. Goes right up into a pyramid. Nice job. Oh!
The Wolfpack, was it good enough to knock off Oklahoma State?
From Raleigh, North Carolina, that was North Carolina State University.
A familiar face in cheerleading. I'm here with James Speed, head coach of Louisville. James, a disappointing preliminary round. You guys finished third because of a legality deduction. What adjustments did you have to make?
Well, we went back through the entire routine. We fixed and made sure that everything was completely appropriate for NCAA, for all viewers of all ages. We thought we'd already done that, but every year you want to raise the bar, and especially when people are starting to backslide a little bit, we like to be the example for the rest of the country. We know a lot of people look up to us, so we want to make sure that the high school kids, all-star kids, have something that's appropriate for them and that is more of a sport-related for them to look up to and for them to aspire to be.
Thanks a lot, James. Good luck today.
Thank you very much.
The Wolfpack awaiting the
we
word.
We have the score for North Carolina State University, 8.62. Our leaders remain.
So North Carolina State in third place, but a drop from their 8.97 in the prelims, and Oklahoma State continues to lead the way with their 8.96. But the defending champs are up next when we return to Daytona Beach.
Come on, everybody. This year's biggest splash, the new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A. Rebuilt from the wheat bun up, it's our best char-grilled chicken sandwich ever.
Ding!
You are now free to dip your toes in the ocean.
Ding!
Ding!
You are now free to see an old friend.
To forget what traffic sounds like.
Free to find your favorite state flower.
Ding!
Ding!
That ding is just cracking me up.
You are now free to get a low fare, even at the last minute.
Ding!
Ding!
You are now free to follow your favorite team.
Ding!
Ding!
You're now free to enjoy low fares coast to coast.
With frequent nonstops to 59 cities.
You are now free to move about the country.
There's a stretch of sparkling white sand that runs for 23 miles along Florida's east coast. Some call it relaxing. Some, a playground. Some call it Daytona Beach, but most simply call it fun. Call toll-free now for a free Daytona Beach visitor guide and superior small lodging brochure filled with affordable vacation ideas. The water's warm. The natives are friendly. All you have to do is make time.
New from Secret. Body sprays.
Oh, yeah!
Discover the secret body spray that goes with your style. And smell great. Anytime, anywhere.
Sweet.
Find us near your other favorite secret products.
Big names at the top of the leaderboard at the Shell Houston Open, including John Daly. This is yesterday. Daly over the trees at the 18th. Setting up birdie and a round of 67. Gavin Coles leads, Singh, Daly, Maggart, and others two back. Third round coverage coming up on CBS.
One of the most notable associations for the Daytona Beach area is the great tradition of NASCAR, and visitors can now experience that year-round at Daytona USA. But hey, we have Speed here in the cheerleading circles too, with the longtime coach of the 10-time champs, James Speed.
Got it? We are a team, and we will win or not win as a team. It's a lot more fun to win, though, so y'all go out there and hit the stuff. Woo!
These Louisville cheerleaders have had a busy year. In addition to all their preparation for this championship, they also followed their basketball team all the way to St. Louis and the Final Four.
The 10 national championships they've won since 1985 has created a winning tradition at Louisville that attracts top talents from across the country.
No third in the prelims. This is a very confident group of Louisville Cardinals trying to win for the third straight time in the cheer competition of the Chick-fil-A Cheer Dance Collegiate Championship.
Very nice. Rewind up. Right up to bow and arrow. That's where they pull their leg completely across. The bases are traveling. Excellent job.
Beautiful start.
This Louisville team, as always, has an action-packed routine. There's constant stunts and tumbling.
Well, Coach James P. told us, if they hit the routine, he does not feel anybody can touch them, as evidenced by their high raw score of 9.5, as we mentioned, the top overall score in the prelims, but the deduction brought them down to 9. They made some adjustments, though, after getting the legality deduction.
Watch this in the back. A double awesome. He's holding two girls, one on each arm, but what's going on in the front is what Louisville's known for. They have unbelievable tumbling. It really separates them. Not only is it flawless, they have beautiful technique.
Even the mascot can do a standing double pull.
Beautiful kick double.
Well, last year, they just blew away the competition here with a 9.63 to win. Second place was 8.95. This year, the competition is a lot tighter when you look at the scores.
Wow. Excellent. 2-1-1 pyramid. So far, so good. This is where they made adjustments to their routine. They put in more palm movements, which they feel is actually going to make the routine better. It's a lot cleaner.
The routine a little more traditional. The judges will certainly appreciate that. Very crisp. And always with a lot of style.
getting ready for full squat standing backs. Very difficult at the end of the routine, and not a hand went down.
He nailed it. A familiar spot for the Louisville Cardinals. As they bid to take over first place and try and hang on here.
Here's their 2-1-1 pyramid. This takes a lot of strength. The girls in the highest tier being held by one guy with one hand.
Wow.
Not only difficult, done to perfection.
How did the judges like it?
We have the score for the University of Louisville. 9.44.
A lot.
Our new leaders in Division 1.
In a familiar spot, back on top, but still two teams to go. Clemson Tigers are up next. So don't go away.
Come on, let's go.
Para bailar la bamba.
This year's biggest splash, the new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A. Rebuilt from the wheat bun up, it's our best char-grilled chicken sandwich ever.
There's a stretch of sparkling white sand that runs for 23 miles along Florida's East Coast. Some call it relaxing. Some, a playground. Some call it Daytona Beach. But most simply call it fun. Call toll-free now for a free Daytona Beach visitor guide and superior small lodging brochure filled with affordable vacation ideas. The water's warm. The natives are friendly. All you have to do is make time.
New from Secret. Body sprays.
Oh, yeah!
Discover the secret body spray that goes with your style. And smell great. Anytime, anywhere.
Sweet.
Find us near your other favorite secret products.
CDS Sports Spectacular presents Chick-fil-A Cheer and Dance Collegiate Championship. Sponsored by Secret. Strong enough for a woman. Daytona Beach. This year, make time for Daytona Beach. And by Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich.
Uncharted waters for Clemson University. Number one in the prelims, but they've never finished higher than seventh in the finals. Louisville leads with a 9-4-4. Oklahoma State, 8-9-6. Oklahoma, Amanda, was second in the prelims, but a disappointing final day for them.
You know, there's a lot of pressure when you're one of the teams to beat, and it seemed like they had one small mistake that kind of snowballed into more mistakes, and they just didn't quite nail this routine.
Former champ here in 1993, the Sooners, with a score of 8.45. So the crowd getting set to see if this newcomer to the scene, Clemson, can overtake the Cardinals. Well, great opportunity here for Clemson University, first in the prelims. They heard that score of 9.44 put up by Louisville. And that is going to be a tough number to hit. Let's see if they can do it.
Very nice bow and arrow, showing great flexibility. Right there, that's a move they're known for. It's called the Tiger Twist. They pull right back up into Scorpion.
Kind of a stretch whirly, which is a playoff of Louisville's big move, and that's not the only connection with Louisville they have.
That's right. Assistant coach Christy Smith was a former Louisville cheerleader.
Won four championships with the Cardinals.
This is an area they've really worked on. They felt like they lacked tumbling in the past. This year, they've really stepped it up. Beautiful double full.
Well, last year, they were seventh, matching their best score ever. This year, they have a chance to be right there.
Showing great height on those basket tosses.
They were the only team in the prelims without a deduction. And as you mentioned earlier, they need to be near perfect, if not absolutely perfect, to win.
Very solid pyramid. All their coaches wanted them to do today was come out here and hit this routine. They said the rest is in the judges' hands.
The top two was the goal coming in. That got revised after they were number one at the prelims.
Very nice. Sharp motion. Excellent job. Woo! Oh my goodness. Oh.
Ah, beautiful.
She swung through. It looked like they actually lost balance a little bit, but they kept it together.
What a finish for Clemson. Is it enough?
Craig, this is a move I actually performed in gymnastics, but remember, my equipment didn't move like that. Wow.
Clemson on the left, Louisville on the right. They're 9-4-4, the score to beat.
We have the score for Clemson University. 9-4-1-6.
They did it again. Louisville, a three-time straight defending champion. Here's Tracy with the winners.
James, congratulations. Congratulations to the whole Cardinal team. We talked earlier about the third place finish in prelims, the adjustments you had to make. How proud are you with the way this team responded?
I am so proud of all of them because they let nothing bother them. They did everything that I asked them to do, and they just kept giving, and performing on that mat. I'm very proud.
You got the hat trick now, three straight championships. What does this mean to the Louisville program?
We are very excited because at NCA, no one has ever won three in a row with Division 1A, and we were wanting to break that jinx for us and for everyone else, hopefully, and we're very excited that we did it.
You're very familiar with that Clemson team. What about the way that they did and how they pushed you through it?
I am so proud of Clemson, of Oklahoma State. Leroy was an assistant coach under me and cheered for me. Christy is Shannon's wife. They did a great job. I worked with them during the year. I'm so proud of all of us. We all did a great job.
James, I don't know what it is that you do, but you should bottle it up and sell it because you're consistently successful. Congratulations to everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Congrats to Louisville as they captured their 11th title, and the tradition continues.
And coming up next, the PGA Tour on CBS takes you to the Redstone Golf Club in the Lone Star State for all the action at the Shell Houston Open. Congratulations to Brigham Young University for their dance championship and all the teams competing here. For Amanda Borden and Tracy Wolfson, I'm Craig Benavini saying so long from Daytona Beach.
Americans are heading to this hospital in India for everything from heart surgery to facelifts. Why? Find out tomorrow on 60 Minutes.
The final three new episodes of Everybody Loves Raymond begin CBS Monday, May 2nd.
Just one look at this mouth-watering...